In this video, I'm going to show you all the features of the sampler plugin within Native Instruments Machine. I'm Garth Richards from MachineMinuteTips.com. Let's get right into it. On page one, there is voice settings /engine, which allows you to control the polyphony, glide, and pitch bend settings. Polyphony defines the maximum number of simultaneous voices. Glide, if legato is selected from the polyphony type, adjusts the duration of the transition between consecutive notes. Pitch bend customizes the reaction to MIDI pitch bend messages. In the engine mode, there are several different selections you can choose from. When you select standard, you are then given several different options. The MPC 60 emulates the legendary sampler and is used in hip hop and many other genres. The ES1200 emulates another legendary sampler with various filtering options. Page two of the sampler plugin, you have tune to adjust the basic pitch of your sample. You have start, which determines the sampler's or the sample start point. You also have reverse to play the sample backwards. And you also have type, which allows you to select from three different amplitude types. And they are one shot, AHD, and ADSR. Just gonna touch on the amplitude envelope. The amplitude envelope section allows you to tailor your sample in terms of its loudness over time. Amplitude envelope parameters control the attack, hold, decay, sustain, and release characteristics of the sound. And like I said earlier, the type selector gives you the ability to choose from three envelope types. In the one-shot selection, when a sample is triggered, it is played in its entirety from beginning with no envelope. In the second selection type, AHD, it disables the sustain and release controls and replaces them with hold parameter for when you would like to have the sound triggered for amount of time, regardless of how long you hold the pad down. The third selection type, ADSR, is used for longer sustained samples that require complex dynamic control. For example, in envelope types AHD and ADSR, you have attack. This determines how quickly the sound reaches full volume after being triggered. In AHD only, you have hold, which determines how long the envelope will stay at its maximum level. Also in AHD and ADSR, you have decay, which determines how fast the envelope drops to the sustain level in ADSR mode, and in AHD mode, it adjusts how fast the sound dies down. In ADSR mode only, you have sustain, which determines the constant level being kept after decay until the note ends. And lastly, in ADSR, you have release. This determines how long the note takes to fade out after the note has ended. On page three of the sampler plugin, you have effects/filter. In the effects section, there is comp, drive, SR, and bits. Comp adds density to a sound with a basic compressor. Drive controls the amount of saturation applied to a sound. SR adjusts the sample rate to create a lo-fi effect. And lastly, bits reduces the bit depth for a rough digital lo-fi sound. In the filter section, you can choose from four different filter types. LP2 defines the low-pass filter with cutoff and resonant parameters. BB2 defines the band-pass filter with a cutoff parameter. HP2 defines a high-pass filter with cutoff and resonance parameters. The EQ defines the equalizer with frequency, bandwidth, and gained parameters. And then obviously, lastly, you can have this filter completely turned off by selecting off here. Combined, these features allow you to shape the effects and filters applied to your sound in the sampler. Page 4 on the sampler plugin is for modulation. The modulation envelope section offers additional envelope for modifying specific sampler parameters. It allows modulation of parameters based on playing of the pads. The parameters match these of the amplitude envelope section on page 2. Two envelope options are available: ADSR, attack, decay, sustain, release, and AHD, attack, hold, and decay. In one-shot mode, only the AHD envelope is available for modulation. Page 5 on the sampler plugin is for LFO. On the LFO, you have two sections, the LFO section and the destination section. The LFO is short for low frequency oscillator and is a modulation source with different waveform shapes. There are 5 different waveform shapes you can choose from in the LFO type. They would be sine wave, triangle, rectangle, saw, and random. The speed control adjusts the rate of the LFO measured in hertz. Sync option shows note values instead of hertz when activated. The phase control sets the initial phase of the LFO waveform, ranging from -0.50 to 0.50. The sync selector synchronizes the LFO with the tempo of your project. Choose between free, independent of tempo, retrig, restarts LFO at each new note, or lock, keep LFO phase synced to the song position for all notes. In the destination section, when using the LFO, you can define modulation targets for the LFO to control. The knobs allow you to adjust the amount of modulation for the following targets. Pitch modulates the tune parameter of the pitch gate section of the pitch envelope page. Cutoff modulates the cutoff perimeter of the filter section with filter types LP2, HP2, BP2 only on the effects page filter page. Drive modulates the drive parameter of the effects section of the effects filter page. Pan modulates the pan parameter on the audio page of the sound's output properties. By adjusting the modulation amount, you can create dynamic and evolving changes in pitch, cutoff, drive, and pan based on the LFO waveform. And lastly, on the sampler plugin in the control area is page 6. And that's for the velocity mod wheel. You have two sections here, velocity destination and mod wheel destination. In the velocity destination section, it allows you to use the input velocity in order to modulate various parameters. Start modulates the start parameter of the pitch gate section of the pitch envelope page. Positive values shape the sample start position later as velocity increases, while negative values shift it closer to the beginning of the sample as velocity increases. Useful for emphasizing attack transients or creating dynamic variations in your sound. Decay modulates the decay parameters of the amplitude envelope. It adjusts the speed at which the envelope drops to sustain level based on velocity and allows for dynamic control over the release phase of the sound. Cutoff controls the cutoff parameter of the filter section with filter types LP2, HP2, BP2 only on the effects filter page on page 3. LFO depth adjusts how much the modulation wheel affects the depth of the LFO modulation for all targets, which is defined on the LFO page, page 5. And lastly, we have pan. Pan controls the pan parameter on the audio page of the sound's output properties, which allows you to adjust the stereo placement of your sound. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share with your friends and family. I'm Garth Richards for MachineMinuteTips.com, and I'll be seeing you in the next one.